Hello there, I'm Joshua the File Heaven, and today we are having a look at a very special product. This is the Roxanne Caspian M2 integrated amplifier. So this is a very large speaker amplifier which delivers way more than its promised 85 watts per channel into 4 ohms. This is even better than that. So I will try to use this little table beside me to do the unboxing, because the amplifier is quite heavy. It has a very huge and powerful power delivery. I am very happy with it. So starting with those, we have a power cord inside the package. This is not an audiophile typical power cord with lots of butterflies and things. This is a very, very simple basic power cord. We also have some paperwork, along with a little remote for the Caspian M2. Now, the amplifier itself is quite heavy. It is also packaged well and protected inside the package. I will try to get you a little peek of what is going on in terms of packaging, but it is quite heavy and I'm afraid that it will fall off. So this is how it comes packaged in its box. I will try to pull it out, show it to you a bit better. It is really, really heavy. So if you are coming from portables or from headphones and EMs and the world of portable, you are not used to very heavy devices. Even the heaviest of the headphone amplifiers tends to be, I'm sorry, I just tripped on over my microphone. I hope you will not get bombarded with noise. Anyways, this is the amplifier. This is the belly of the amplifier. And this is the front, although this is how it should look like. This is quite a few kilos of weight. It has a very heavy and large power delivery. This is how it looks like. And this is how it looks like from the top. I for one, am a fan of the design. I know that quite a few people weren't such big fans of the design, and I don't blame them. Everyone has their own tastes, but for me, I think that the amplifier looks quite handsome. On the back, you have here the XLR input. You have the RCA input for the preamp. You have a pre-output. You have a power amp input. And here you have the power amp output, which is right here on those ones. I am doing my best to do this review, but this one is way too heavy to be practical for a video review like this. So here is the power output, and here is the actual power wall input. The thing so heavy in it is the actual power transformer, which is very heavy, and it is a heavy duty power transformer which provides quite enough power for your speakers. Now, this new version, this is the newer version of M2. Basically, what Roxanne is doing, they have provided the newer built versions with more updates, and the newest versions also come with some little tweaks in terms of build quality. Like this one, I think that something interesting has gone, because the newer version still has that little fan which kicks in if the power amplifier needs it, which makes it cool better. And it will not overheat. This means that you can really, really drive your speakers loud. Now, in terms of testing, I have tested it with a few speakers, including the Taga Harmony I've reviewed before. I will leave a link in the video description. Now, in terms of driving power, this one is capable of driving everything under the sun. There are very few speakers that would need more than this Caspian M2 here. It has not only enough power, I will try to keep it in such a way that you see it while I'm talking. So I think that this is the most practical way for me to hold it. I think it doesn't look quite so handsome, does it? No, I don't think it does, but at least I'm doing something. Now, I could have used the table for this review. Now that I'm thinking about it, I really should have used the table. But anyways, I will try to do my best and hold it like this. So I hope my head doesn't look like it's being cut. So in terms of driving power, It has enough power to drive everything under the sun. But in terms of actual sonic characteristics, it has a very wide soundstage, it has a precise soundstage, it has very good instrument separation, it has a ton of dynamics, of punch, it delivers one of the most beautiful sounds I ever heard in an amplifier. It pairs well with both normal speakers as well as ribbon speakers and as well as those trumpet shaped speakers. I don't even know how to call them in English, they are named guarnă in Romanian. And yeah, so it pairs well with pretty much everything. I think that the weight is distributed better if I hold it like this. Not quite the most interesting of positions for a serious audio reviewer, but it does the job for me being able to talk about it. Now, I think that this can make your endgame amplifier if you don't have need of a more powerful amplifier. Now, some people were not fans of the entire design, but I for one didn't think it was bad. I think it was pretty cool actually. The volume knobs here look pretty handsome. As far as I remember, you can also control them from the remote. I have not unpacked or used the remote at all. I really like the top of the amplifier as well, since you will be seeing this one in your system. It is a pretty interesting design, I really like it. It tends to attract fingerprints though. In terms of sound, it has a very linear kind of sound. It doesn't provide any kind of coloration, but this also means it provides very, very good treble performance. Very clear kind of sound, a lot of detail. I haven't heard this detail in a really, really long time. And this is about, what, 2000 euros at this point, at the point of making this review. It has been a bit cheaper. It also has gone a bit more expensive. The price varies with the currency exchange rate, but anyways, it provides a very clear, very crisp kind of sound, very good detail, impressive dynamics. It really punches you in the face, it really comes at you, the sound just jumps at you. It is that type of sound that really scares you, and that is good, because this is the type of sound that is realistic. It really provides a very real kind of sound. It doesn't drown out the details. But if your music is slower, like jazz, it provides a very musical kind of experience. It really does everything as an amplifier should. Paired with a good DAC like the M2 Tech Young Mark III or the Mytek Brooklyn DAC Plus or Aune S6, this is going to last you for a really long while, and it is going to provide a really fun experience to you. I mean, I don't mean this just as a reviewer. This is my personal unit. This has not been sent by Roxanne. This is my personal unit, and I am in love with it. It is just so good. I mean, usually I compliment things, or it may seem like I compliment things, because you may think that I like a company, but that is not true. I also critique things that I've received from companies. I tend to compliment whatever I like and critique whatever I don't like. I try to be honest with you guys, because this is what a reviewer should do. I should just be honest always about thoughts and about how I feel about things. And I'm honest about this one. I really love it. I even think that I don't really feel the need for an upgrade. I don't feel the itch for an upgrade at this point. I have been using the Roxanne Caspian M2, and I don't feel like there is something that would power my speakers much better. I will be reviewing some very interesting speakers in a really, really short while, and you should really stay tuned for those. Besides some interesting soundbars and some interesting more normal products, I have some really, really good speakers coming along. Now, if there is something else to mention about the Roxanne, it has a input selector here which clicks. I hope you can hear it. Which can click between the inputs, and it has a mode button here. Other than that, it has a tape button here, and there is the volume wheel. It is an integrated amplifier, and this is pretty much everything that is written on the package. There is a little button here on the bottom, which I assume is the on-off power switch, but yeah, that one should be it. Other than this, I think you would be very happy if you decide to purchase the Roxanne Caspian M2. This is going to provide you with that kind of sound that really pinches you. Like when something, when an instrument is hit, you hear it. You hear the dynamics that a real live performance should have. This is something I've been missing from music for a long while. I've always missed that kind of live, that when a drummer hits the drums, when you hear that, when you really, it should really mean something to you. And the Roxane Caspian M2 really paints that well. Of course, if your speakers are also capable of that, I do not recommend getting the cheapest speakers and relying on them to provide that kind of sound. So, very, very soon I will be providing a review with of what I have been pairing the Roxane Caspian M2 with to get those results. I hope you will be ready for that video. I hope you have a lovely week in there. I hope to see you soon, and consider subscribing to my YouTube channel and liking this video if you had fun watching it. I thank you for watching, and I hope you have a lovely week in there. Bye-bye!